How did Ice-T become financially free? We will be talking about his music, acting, and investments. Starting with some background, Ice-T, born Tracy Morrow, is an OG in the hip-hop industry, first rising to popularity in 1987. He adopted the name Ice-T in 1983 after his favorite writer, Iceberg Slim, which is when he would start his career professionally, showcasing his skills in any outlet that let him. After gaining some traction, Ice-T would sign to Sire Records, where he would release his debut album, Rhyme Pays. In the 90s, Ice-T would be the lead man for the heavy metal band Body Count, only growing his career further. Following the rise of Ice-T, he would quickly brand himself outside of just music, being featured in movies and TV shows, building up a resume in that field quick. Ice-T spread himself out in music and other media to grow his brand, opening more opportunities like investments, which I'm excited to get into. Before we talk about his investments, we need to talk about the music and label. Going into music, Ice-T has released over 15 projects throughout his career, with 8 of those being studio albums. As for Ice-T, it's been since 2006 when he last released a studio album titled Gangsta Rap. However, his band Body Count has released 4 albums since then, with a new album on the way. Of Ice-T's 8 studio albums, 4 have gone gold, each equivalent to 500,000 sales, and his album Power in 1988 went platinum, equivalent to 1 million album sales. These sales reflect the early influence that Ice-T had on hip-hop, getting listeners to leave their homes to purchase physical copies. He is part of the push that changed music, leading to hip-hop and rap to becoming one of the most listened to genres in the world. It wouldn't have happened without artists like Ice-T driving in those early sales in the late 80s and early 90s. For his label situation, like I mentioned, Ice-T signed to Sire Records, which is a subsidiary of Warner Music, in 1987 and quickly released his debut album, Rhyme Pays, that is certified gold selling. He would have 4 albums under Sire Records until eventually leaving the label in 1993 after Warner Music blocked his 5th studio album from dropping due to his band's controversial song, Cop Killer. This was just a small setback, as Ice-T would quickly sign to Priority Records to release 3 more albums. His last album in 2006 was released independently. Overall, when we talk about music, Ice-T played a critical role in moving the sound to where it is today. If it wasn't for people like him pushing boundaries at the time, raking in sales, the hip-hop genre may not be the same today. All while doing this, he was expanding his personal brand, his business outside of music with acting and investments. Talking about acting, Ice-T started taking this lane seriously in 1991 with his role in the movie New Jack City, and now has been featured in over 50 movies and TV shows since then. While taking roles in movies were successful in building his acting brand, the biggest role he would get would be when he was introduced to Law & Order, becoming a series regular on their Special Victims Unit show in 2000, which is now one of the longest running shows on TV. It is reported that he makes around $250,000 per episode. Ice-T has been on 456 episodes, making him the second most appearing character on the show, and if he was paid $250,000 per episode, that is $114 million made just from his appearances, not including royalties. While music is where Ice-T originally built his brand, Law & Order is where Ice-T built his empire. Now onto my favorite section, and that is investments. When talking about Ice-T's investments, the first one I want to talk about is his investment into cannabis. Earlier this past year, in August 2022, it was announced that the New Jersey Control Board approved the opening to a recreational cannabis store, The Medicine Woman, which Ice-T is invested in. The Medicine Woman retail brand was started in California by former Playboy playmate Charis Barret and is now expanding to the East Coast. This comes after only just a few months of New Jersey legalizing recreational marijuana, so this was a quick attack on the market by Ice-T. With how fast the cannabis industry is growing, this is a good foot in the door to take market share in the now growing New Jersey market with potential to expand. When Ice-T talks about investments, a lot of it comes in the form of advice. I found this specific piece of advice important to mention because so often I myself and many others are looking for outside ways to invest money to make a quick return. For Ice-T, he looks to invest into his bank or himself that can provide more money-making opportunities. This is reinvesting your earnings into yourself. For him, this is reinvesting earnings into an album or a business idea. For someone like you and I, this can be investing our earnings into a hobby or side hustle that will grow money. It's not good to be always so outside looking when there is potential to grow your investments through yourself. Overall, when talking about investments, Ice-T mainly has given his thoughts on investments, which indicates he is most likely invested into securities like stocks and bonds, keeping his portfolio diverse. It is cool to see him taking on new investments into the cannabis industry, since that is a rapidly growing market. Investments may not be the breadwinner for Ice-T, but they are what help him retain and grow his bank. This leads me to the question, what is next for Ice-T? As for music, it has been over a decade since his last solo studio album. However, there are plans for his band Body Count to release a new album in 2023. The clear focus for him has been through acting, whether that's in TV, movies, or voicing, and I don't think that will change anytime soon. He is bringing in hundreds of millions from one TV show. For his investments, the New Jersey cannabis store has yet to open, but with the approval, that will be a good entry into the industry. I'll be sure to cover any new investments made by Ice-T into startup or established companies here on my channel. What is next for Ice-T? Continuing to cash in on his long resume he has been building since the 80s. In summary, Ice-T is an OG in the music hip-hop game, part of the push that led the sound to where we hear it today. This is reflected in his early sales, getting people to leave their homes to buy albums while pushing boundaries. During this, he was building up his acting career, which would end up making him more money than music due to his tenure on one of the longest running TV shows. Now he continues to find ways to expand his personal brand with new ventures like into cannabis that have lots of growth potential. Ice-T wasn't just satisfied with music, but wanted to expand his reach early on, leading him to be set up for life, becoming financially free. And that is how Ice-T became financially free. I hope you found this video informational. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe, as well as let me know who I should talk about next. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.